Alright, we've eaten now, and now we're here at Helmkost again. And now showing The Boom, 1945 to 1960 in Clay County. See how Clay County changed in the years after World War II in our new exhibit opening, January 27, 2012. The GI Bill, the Baby Boom, Housing Boom, Consumer Boom, Farming Boom, Civil Defense, Korean War, and the Cold War. Clay County is the county adjacent to Cass County, North Dakota, home of Fargo, North Dakota, and World Wide Web Blizzard Artist Gallery.com, your sponsor. Where, in fact, is...
I don't know, that says 2009 flood there. Flood.
No, here it is, the boom down here. Yes, the boom. The boom. Stay and dine in Minnesota. All right, the big attraction here is typically the Grand Ship, but today is the opening of Boom. Boom in Clay County. A tractor? Wow. Wow. There's the 1951 cannon.
It's been here before.
Wow. Call it the boom. The post-war years from 1946 to 1960 were a time of tremendous technological, social, and economic change for Clay County. Through the Depression of the 1930s, residents had little money to buy things. From 1941 to 1945, folks had money, but World War II rationing left little to purchase. That all changed after the war. The nation's economy boomed as war production shifted to new consumer products. The GI Bill of Rights provided returning vets with financial help to go to college and buy homes. Many left farm life for jobs in town. The birth rates skyrocketed as folks married younger and had more kids. Moorhead's population doubled in 15 years. The sudden affluence brought a new generation of teenagers, cars, a new musical style, and time to enjoy both. New agricultural technologies, such as better machinery, new herbicides and pesticides, new crops and varieties made farming easier and more productive. Electricity and indoor plumbing brought farm families amenities their city neighbors had enjoyed for decades and saved a huge amount of hard labor. One-room country school disappeared as students attended consolidated schools in cities. International tensions with the Soviet Union threatened nuclear devastation, and aggressive brought civil defense measures. Young Clay County men went to war again in the far-off Korea. Four died in service. In 15 years after the end of World War II, Clay County, like the rest of the country, entered the modern age. Absolutely. No, only the, well, maybe the big ones. Here's an army uniform of Arnold R. Anderson of Holly. Very interesting. Welcome home. Here comes the troops in 1947. 2,000 vets participated. Veterans deserve all the help society can give them. You agree, don't you?
Yes,
Mr.
Yes.
Of course.
That's not on there.
That's not on there, but it's a truism. It's so true that we barely need to refer to it every 2 minutes.
What about that, 275 Moorhead vets?
Moorhead vets. need Social Security disability. Wow. The soldiers return. Welcome home. Nearly 3,000 Clay County men and women answered the call to arms in World War II. About 70 died in service. The rest returned to a country in transformation, disappearing with the deprivations of the 1930s and the rationing of the war years. The economy was roaring and there were lots of jobs. Makes me want to go out and get 3 jobs to honor the vets. No. During the war, many women entered the workforce to replace men who left for service. With the return of the servicemen, many lost their jobs. Before the war, Moorhead's Fairmont Creamery's workforce were 16% women. That rose to over 56% in 1945, but dropped down to 26% after the war in 1948. There were programs to ease the vets back into civilian life. In 1944, Congress passed the GI Bill of Rights. This legislation provided unemployment compensation to returning vets and no down payment, low interest loans for building homes. It also granted vets money for college or tech school education. Late in 1945, the Clay County Commission appointed a veteran service officer to aid vets in securing the GI Bill benefits coming to them. Wartime shortages of, especially building materials, lasted in the late 1940s. The huge demand created a severe housing shortage, especially in Moorhead. Vets and their young families crammed into trailers and tiny cabins in the city's tourist camp, north of the Center Avenue Bridge. 26 other veterans' families moved into RV surplus barracks in a federal development on 12th Avenue North, between 13th and 14th Streets. Hansman Park now sits on the site. Informal trailer parks popped up on Moorhead's outskirts. I wonder what an informal... Oh, non-organized? You just pull in your trailer and...
Probably, yeah.
Just like mine it after the flood.
Yeah.
Just pell-mell.
Yeah.
Waiting for a free trailer.
Nearly 175 people spent the winter of 46, 47 in small trailers like these ones. In
the Moorhead Tourist Camp.
The camp was located just a block south of where you were standing.
On the north side.
Of the Center Avenue Bridge.
Wow. Good living there. Nice. There's Ben Gustafson in his seed treating machine, right? There's the Fairmont Creamery. It's only a couple blocks away. When did the Fairmont Creamery shut down? It looks not so long ago. Maybe 10, 15 years,
maybe? Maybe.
Here's the creamery. Wow. Wow. Now we will pause in silence, remembering the suffering of those in mind in North Dakota. And now, the silence. Thank you for participating in that moment of silence for mine in North Dakota. It's done now. College admission explodes. Wow. Of college admissions. Dropped to historic lows during World War II. That's because everyone's in the war. Prefab buildings are put up to help the young veterans. Note, the rural schools in 1946, and then the rural schools in 1960. Ooh, we're down to one. The Lincoln Logs. These aren't actual Lincoln Logs, they're square American logs. I had Lincoln Logs.
These are what, square American?
Square American logs.
Okay.
It's counter-juxtapositioned with Lincoln Logs.
Right.
Indeed. Did you have Lincoln Logs?
No.
You did have Badgers.
I did have Badgers, yes.
How were they to play with?
Not so good.
So good. How did they sharpen their paws, anyway? Let's see what Mom's doing over in the kitchen. The boom was a time of change in agriculture. Hey, there's a big auction tomorrow at Villiards, you know. I bet it'll be lots of glassware. Lots of glassware. There's Mom. Mom didn't have much of a personality.
No, pretty nondescript. Just like her child there.
What? What?
The child behind the chair.
Oh. Where'd see the child? Wow.
Girl.
I sense a golden future for her, too.
Linoleum.
Real linoleum. Wow. Love Old and McDonald, general contractors. the Little Outhouse on the Prairie. Outstanding.
Little shit house on the prairie.
Wow. We had a three-holer out in the farm.
Oh, did you?
It came down in the 90s, I suppose. We finally took it down completely.
15% only have indoor plumbing in 1946. It's rough. Best used outdoors is similar to when going to the bathroom. Outhouses could be cold, smelly, unhealthy, uncomfortable, and inconvenient.
Inconvenient. But, wow. They should really have Sears Roebuck catalogs rather than that nice toilet paper.
Yeah, that's right.
Housing boom. Tract housing. Cold War begins. The Korean War. Hard, cold, forgotten. Shelters, fallout shelters. Here is the high-tech washing machines. Roll Tog. Wow, really nice.
I remember my mom having one.
A Coronado?
Huh?
A Coronado brand?
I don't
brand?
Know if it was a Coronado, but it was built very similar to this. Had the rollers up on top.
Mm-hmm.
And they had
mm-hmm.
the tub here. Yeah, it was just
yes,
like,
yes.
I mean, it could have been.
Ooh, the Etsy sketch is here. A 1928 study found that Minnesota farm families spent about 38-hour days per year just pumping and hauling water. Wow, that's too much. Agriculture innovations continue. Civil defense things. This has been an overview of the great boom of 1945 to 1960 in Clay County, Minnesota. Admission today is free. So our thanks to the staff and management of the Helm Coast Clay County Museum and of course, our filming sponsor is World Wide Web, BlizzardArtistGallery.com of Fargo, North Dakota, located primarily in Antiques on Broadway, number 6 Broadway North, Fargo, North Dakota, 701-451-9111. Mark E. Nelson, proprietor. Thank you so very much. Signing off from the Helm Coast.